that you don't deserve, is that right? You earn, or you, is that right? Respect is something you what? Earn, right? It's not something that people just automatically just bestow upon you. Something that you have to what? Earn. And I think the thing that created that respect was the fact that we had spent God knows how many hours the old Northsiders spent on their knees. The old Northsiders. The old time Northsiders. I don't know how many of y'all fit in that category. Amen. Some of y'all do. All of those hours on their knees crying out to God. Sometimes some of y'all looking at me right now went through 20 days consecration, 7 days, 10 days. And the hours that we spent at this altar crying out to God. Crying out to God. Amen. And I believe that when they pick up those little manuals and begin to share them with their congregations and with their districts and with their states, sometimes bishops have used the manuals for state material when he calls all of the pastors together and he was sharing. In fact, I've been in some of them where they had me to share some of the materials to the entire congregation, the entire group of missionaries and ministers and district superintendents and all of that. But what I believe, what they feel, what they sense of the respect that this material has produced was caused from not a whole lot that I get in myself. It was because of the anointing.
Amen.
It was because of the anointing.
Amen.
That kind of penetrated in these manuals from the prayer and from the consecration and from the commitment that we had made to obey God down through the years. Amen. And believe it or not, it might not translate into a whole lot of dollars, but it's good to go to places and there's an open door and people think a lot of you.
Yes.
And people will open the door for you. Amen. And you can get special privileges when the hundreds of bishops meet in closed chambers. You get special privileges and the opportunity to go in and to share the little bit that God has done through you down through the years in the form of workbooks that really lays a foundation for the Word of God to be shared with people all over the world. Amen. Now, the reason why I would be very foolish to have given up in the midst of my trials and my conflicts. I remember the first time that I pursued this, the Lord had already showed me the end result. So I began to go to places. I called a bishop in Tennessee, and he had about 50 pastors, and I asked him if I could come and share what God had given me. And that was my first time leaving Northside with, I call, a small package of material that probably was designed to help most pastors to teach most of the basic things that they need to teach their people for a period of about 5 years. Amen. And when I shared it about 10 minutes to all of those pastors, amen, the bishop said, Pastor Hill, don't let it all get away. Amen. Save me a pack. Now, don't let it all get away. And we had pastors in line. And just about everything that we took on the first go around, amen, it just ate it up. During those times, you know, about $2,000 was all we made off that. Amen. But I thought that was real good to just start out. Amen. How did I have to borrow the money even to print the books? Amen. But suppose I had stopped in the midst of the trials and hardships and not pursued it and kept going until the materials that we were sharing with just a few people finally began to be used by pastors and ministers in about 40 some different states. Amen. So we kind of have a base of pastors and bishops all over this nation. And whatever I present to them, whatever I share with them, or whatever I begin to suggest to them, something that will be beneficial to them, they are very, very, very open. Amen. To me, that is better than having a whole lot of money in the bank. It is a whole lot better than having it. But God showed me the end result, and because I saw the end result, I didn't quit. Sometimes I try to get up in the morning and write, nothing came. Sometimes I just said, heck with that, maybe I miss God. Amen. Sometimes trying to get from one city to the other, amen, I didn't have any money. And boy, the things I had to go through just to position myself to bring these books to meetings and conventions. I've been all over this place, Birmingham, Florida. I mean, I've been all over, probably about all these different states. And most times when I left Tulsa, I didn't hardly have money to get there. So she would just, I swear, she just followed me around. Much as she wanted to, sometimes she wouldn't go. Because she said, you on your own, Pastor. But she always stood behind me. But we never knew that one day, amen. But I do believe that we're just now getting in a position, really, to, since God has given me the full vision, I believe that we're just now right, amen, to make this ministry known and renowned all over the nation and all over the world, because God has given us favor. Scripture says if you're faithful in the least, then God will make you one ruler over much. How many can see amen? Now, it's a whole lot in being able to see the end result. And how do you see the end result? You know, the end result, many times, God reveals it through dreams and visions. This is how God revealed it through Abraham. He saw the end results through a what? God just took him out. I mean, Abraham, God just showed him a what? A vision. Vision, it was through Joseph, it was a what? A dream. Amen. These things are initiated by God. Visions and dreams are something that God has to initiate. And when God, amen, and most times God will initiate dreams and visions so that he can bring your belief or your faith up to a level where he can really what, work through you and bring to pass the things that God has designed, amen, for you to be and the things that God designed for you to be. Amen. Many times it comes in Old Testament, in particular, I would say Daniel. How could Daniel be so consistent, could be so, hallelujah, so settled and established in his faith when he was thrown in the lion's den? I mean, he didn't sweat it at all. Mm-mm. Amen. But Daniel knew the end from the what? Beginning. He knew exactly what empire would succeed the other and the other and the other. He worked as a statesman, as a politician. In fact, he was the third in command, you know, under one empire. The other empire, he became number one of all of the 120 presidents. And when Cyrus became president, became the emperor, he had great favor with him. But Daniel, amen, saw the end. He knew exactly what was coming down the pipe. He knew how God was working. He knew what direction God was going. So he said, all I got to do is just wrap this thing out. It's going to turn out real good because I can see the end result of what God is going to do. And as a result, Daniel was used mightily. And he was used mightily in visions and in dreams. And he was used to interpret visions and dreams. Amen. And that was the thing that stabilized him. That was his compass. That was the thing that kept him on track.
All the hardship and suffering, we know how they schemed and plotted to destroy him, because the Bible says he was a man without what? Without error. He was faithful. He was consistent. The king, everybody loved him. And everybody was jealous and envious. All of the other presidents were jealous and envious of him. Amen. So he went through, remember, the plot to throw him into the lion's den was because they found a way to accuse him, amen, of what? Praying to the true and living God rather than bowing down to the what? To the emperor. Amen. And as a result of that, they condemned him to be cast into the lion's den. Amen. How many know that he knew exactly how things were going to come out? It's good to know how things are going to come out. Well, you don't have to have a vision. You don't have to have a dream to know how things are going to come out. Amen. Praise God. Sometimes people say, well, what about prayer? What about prayer? You know, prayer is something that you can initiate. God initiates visions and dreams, and everybody ain't going to have a dream, and everybody ain't going to have a vision. Amen. And sometimes people say, if you don't have a vision, if God don't reveal himself, if an angel don't appear, amen, praise God, then what? I haven't heard from God. But God has a sure, amen, a better way to reveal and to make known to us the thing that he would have us to be and to do. And that is through the word of God. How did they say amen? But let me just work with prayer a while. Amen. A person can see more on their knees. Amen. Somebody just come and get on their knees. Sometimes people think they can't praise God. They can't hear from God unless they way up here. Is that everybody right? Okay, now look here. Now I can see like I can see more than, can you see everything on going on? You can see everything going on. She said, okay, so she can see more than her knees than a whole lot of people can see on there. Standing up. All right, that's good, Sister Banks. Hallelujah. So God wants you to see the end result through prayer. Boy, I saw that thing a whole lot of years. I knew how it was going to pan out. Because of fasting 20 and 30 days, and fasting, you don't have to fast 20 or 30 days, but I was consistent in prayer, and God just showed me something. Everything that God reveals to me in terms of my books or my messages and what I'm to say to you every Sunday. Sometimes y'all say, I ain't working, Pastor Hill, has so much to talk about. Well, I hear from God. He has a whole lot to talk. Amen. To what? To share. I hasn't seen it. Neither what? Ear heard it. Neither has it entered into the heart of men. The things that God has prepared for them that love him. But God has revealed those things by his what? Spirit. And believe it or not, usually during the week, I study, I pray, I try to make every prayer meeting, every time there's an opportunity for me to enrich myself, read, meditate, go over books, read books. And then usually, about Saturday, when I'm to minister on Sunday, many times, things haven't really gelled. They haven't come together. I'm not sure whether I'm supposed to do this, I'm supposed to do that. I know I studied this all week, but I'm not sure whether I'm supposed to do this. Maybe part of it. I don't know which part. And then, amen, about 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning on Sunday. That's the time I normally get up. I just sit up and I say, Lord, I've gone over this. You've spoken this to me. I've gone through this. I've done this. I've read this. I've done this book. I've done this DVD. I've done this tape or whatever. I mean, a CD or DVD. And the Lord just began to lay out, here's what you do first. Number 2. Number 3. He just lays it out in a period of 2 or 3 hours when I'm just kind of waiting before him on Sunday morning. And then sometimes it's not laid out and I just have to get up, come up here, and just step out by faith. I don't know what's going to come out. I don't know how you're going to put it together. I don't know how it's supposed to be arranged, but as I step out by faith, then God begins to what?
Yes.
Put the missing pieces together. Some say, that's kind of scary, Pastor. It seems kind of scary or risky. Suppose God don't come through. Amen. Well, the problem is that the point is he always does. God ain't slack concerning his promises. As men count slackness, but it's long-suffering, willing that none would perish, and all will come to repentance.
Amen.
So I'm just showing you how God shows you at the beginning exactly the end results of what he wants you to do or what he wants you to be. And most times it comes through prayer. Prayer. Everybody just said prayer.
Prayer.
Hallelujah. Take somebody and say, prayer is important. You can see a whole lot in prayer that you can't see no other way. And you know, the scripture says he's a rewarder of them that will what? Diligently seek him. Amen. Amen. Somebody said, pray, believe, and receive, or pray, down, and do without. Pray, believe, and receive. Oh, saints, y'all have no idea. I owe my whole life to pray. Because my brother, when we first started out, my brother, he put the thumbs down on me. This was my younger brother. He said, James, you're the sorriest boy I ever seen in my life. I pity the woman that marries you. Amen. He said, you are doomed for what? You ain't gonna be nothing. Amen. But let me tell you, when I got saved and filled with the Holy Ghost and learned how to pray in the Holy Ghost, for hours after hours, man, hallelujah. I said, well, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things pass away. Behold, all things become new. Boy, I got in that prayer thing. And even I was going with Sister Hill, we were courting, going together. Dating, okay. Dating. She said they call it dating. We were going together, and I said, I'm going to see how this prayer is going to match. I got saved first, and after I got saved, I said, I'm just going to pray and just see what effect my prayer will have on this sweet little young lady that I'm going with. I prayed. Well, when I got there with the Holy Ghost, I stayed in the Holy Ghost for about 3 hours. I was just, oh boy, it was, my snot was just coming. Oh, it was finger licking good. I don't mean my snot. I was beating the floor and hollering. Boy, I had never experienced nothing that completely satisfied and fulfilled me inwardly. It was just so good. And when I got through with that experience, I felt like a giant. Although, before that, I felt like a little peon. I felt like I wasn't good for nothing. I felt like I was born to lose. I felt like I would never be anything. I had some things that happened early in my life. I'll tell you about that. My tooth grew out of place, and that messed me up for years because one tooth was about way behind the other one, and I would hold my head up. Boy, it really hurt me emotionally. Even sometimes now, maybe I might not hold my head up. Probably goes way back to that. You'd be surprised how little things can cause an emotional problem and stay with you, you know, almost throughout your lifetime. So I never would talk. I always had my head down if I was going to say anything. But when I met Sister Hill, that had already been fixed. I had a pool and I had a bridge. Y'all understand? So I got rid of that after the 11th grade in high school. But the symptoms of it still followed me. Amen. But when I, after finishing college, after praying through, getting my breakthrough in prayer, amen, I felt like a totally different person. The first thing I remember saying, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things have passed away. And behold, from that day forward, my attitude toward who I was in Christ began to be completely changed. So I began to employ my newfound power and ability, amen, to influence the lady of my life, the young lady, that was Sister Hill. So she was at home. This was a school break period, summertime, summer school was out, she was going home. I got saved and filled with the Holy Ghost, and I wrote a letter. And it wasn't this type of letter. Roses are red, violets are blue, sugar is sweet. So I didn't, not that kind of stuff. You know, I used to say, you are my daily inspirations and my future expectations. I used to, you know, I had a little line, amen. And they call it old fashioned now. Amen. But I wrote in this letter, I say, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. I told her exactly what had happened to me during my experience with the Lord that week. And when she got that letter, amen, God showed her a vision, I understand. A dream. And the Lord showed her that she needed Jesus. She needed Jesus. And a couple of weeks later, she returned. Amen. She gave her life to the Lord, got filled with the Holy Ghost. And we walked in my brother's living room one day just before December with our marriage license. And amen, he married us in his living room. I'm not even sure whether he knew we were coming. Or he didn't know? All right. But it wasn't no formal wedding. Amen. Hey, that shows the power of prayer. Is that right? Yeah. Amen. How many can see the power of prayer? Yeah. Amen. Praise God. Now, the second way you can initiate the power of God. Amen. First, God has to initiate dreams and vision. But there are things that you can initiate where God can show you the end from the beginning. As I said, through prayer. And secondly, through meditation. Everybody say meditation.
Meditation.
Amen. See, and the word really has your future in it.
Amen.
Is that right?
Yes.
The word has already declared, amen, what's going to happen if you stay on a certain path. Whatever you ask the Father in Jesus' name, he will what? Give it. Amen. To me, that sounds like, Brother William, you can call the shot yourself. Whatever you decree. Whatever you decree. Somebody just said, whatever you decree. See, life can go the way that you decree it. Because you have been given power. Everybody just said power and authority. Over all power of the enemy. So Jesus said, whatsoever things ye desire, when you pray.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Believe that ye receive them, and what? Ye shall what? Have them. Whosoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed, and don't doubt in their heart, but believe that those things that they say shall come to pass, shall have whatever they say. So, to me, the greatest challenge that we have as believers is to, amen, whatever it takes for you to expand your believing. That's the thing that's going to eventually result in getting you, taking you over, or, amen, are you going over or are you going under? If you can expand, how many understand what I'm saying? You can expand your believing. You can, amen, see, believing is an accumulation of knowledge. Amen, and you get that knowledge from the Word of God. The entrance of His Word giveth what?
Light.
It giveth understanding to the simple.
Yes, amen.
So we don't understand how important is the Word of God is. See, if I were you, and this is the way it was for me, I would search the Word. Amen. I will determine exactly how the Holy Spirit is leading and directing me. What direction? And I will find in the Word of God exactly what God promises me as a result of what? Hooking up with His Word.
Oh, that's good.
Amen. Praise God. And then I will begin to what? Verbalize it. I will begin to what? Speak it. Because as I begin to speak what God has said, amen, that's the way, praise God, my faith in God's Word begins to what? Grow and develop. Amen. By speaking the Word, amen, and saying the Word, and hearing yourself say the Word through verbalizing it, amen. Somebody's, even the Word says, amen, that the Word of God
is, let me see, how does it go? Praise God. The word of God is life to them that what? Find it. And it's what? Healing to all of their flesh. Yes. See, this is how you build your faith up, by what? Hearing. Faith comes by what? Hearing. Amen. Everybody listen, that faith comes by hearing. So you can feed your heart faith, and then your heart will turn around and what? Feed your mouth faith. Faith comes by what? Hearing. Say it again. Faith comes by what?
Hearing.
Amen. See, eye hasn't seen, neither ear heard, neither has it been revealed to the heart of men the things that God has prepared. And everything that God has prepared is in His Word. How can you say amen?
Amen.
There are some things that you have to get through revelation, prayer, amen. But the basic format that God has provided us is in His Word. So you got to what? Find in the Word what God will do, what God wants you to be. What God wants you to do. Hallelujah. Find it in the Word and when come into agreement, begin to what? Keep that thing before you.
Yes, Lord.
Begin to say it. Hallelujah. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Alright, I'm about done. Hallelujah. Now, verbalize it. Everybody said you got to say the word. How many remember the little handout I gave recently about you are saying what God says about your situation. Y'all have a little handout? So you need to read that because that shows that you can have whatever you say. If you don't say nothing, you don't what? You don't get nothing. Amen. All right. The other aspect of meditation is verbalization. And the second part is, let me get this right, is visualization. Everybody say visualization. Because when you begin to say what God says about your condition, or your future, or what you will be, when you begin to say, then images and a on the screen of your imagination, you will begin to see pictures or images of what you are speaking. How do you understand what I'm saying? So when I was praying, for all those years about books and the writings and things, God would show me pictures and images of me standing before people, letting them know what God had revealed to me. I just saw success that way. I saw it. Hallelujah. How many say words create images and pictures? Amen. That means you can begin to see the end result of what God is eventually going to what? Do through your life. How many believe it's worth praying for? How many believe it's worth meditating for? How many believe it's worth, amen, really focusing on God's word for it?
Yes, amen.
God can make you whatever you want to be. Amen. If you don't be nothing, it's because you don't want to be nothing. Because Jesus said that this is a, well, Paul said this is the confidence that we have in Him. I believe this is in John. That we can ask anything according to His will and He heareth us. Everybody just said, if we ask anything according to His will, He what? Heareth us. Say it again. If you ask anything according to His will, He what? And if we know that we hear, how many know that God hears you when you're praying? If you know, hallelujah, that you have, even that He heareth us, then you know you have the petitions of the things you have what? Asked Him for. Amen. Praise God. So you know that you know when you ask according to God's will and you do it in faith. How many can say amen? All right. The last part of meditation after visualization, you begin to the rejoicing part. In other words, when you see the end result, when God shows you, amen, what you will eventually be, what you will eventually do, when you see the end result, then God wants you to what? He wants you to rejoice. He wants you to praise Him. He wants you to get very excited. See, these are things you can initiate. These are things you can do, amen, in order for you to experience the end result from the beginning. Now, the points that I wanted to make, and I'm done, it eliminates frustration when you can see the end results from the beginning. It eliminates frustration, which we can become preoccupied with in the present. You see the end results of what God promises. So that means that it can eliminate frustrations, which can get you caught up in them. You can become preoccupied with them. But when you see the end results, amen, you can rejoice, and it will eliminate frustration. How many thank God you have a way of eliminating frustrations from your life? Hallelujah. Number two, it gives you purpose and focus in the now. Keeps you on track. Amen. It gives you purpose and focus in the now. It keeps you on track. Number three, these are the results, the end results. Amen. These are the results of being able to see the end from the beginning. Number three, it gives you the energy and motivation to move forward regardless of adverse conditions and circumstances. It gives you energy. When you know how things are going to turn out, when you can see it through the eyes of faith, it gives you energy. Everybody say, it gives you energy and motivation. Turn around and tell somebody, it gives you energy and motivation when you know. It gives you energy and what? Motivation. Keeps you from wasting your time, talent, and treasure, your money, choosing to stay home instead of coming to church to get information, to expand your believing, or sitting on your talent, or putting your money in bags with holes. So it keeps you from wasting your time, talent, and treasure. Because many times when people get frustrated, they stay home, blame God, feel sorry for themselves, have a pity party. But when you know the end result, you're not going to get involved in a what? Pity party. You're going to what? Rejoice, because you know exactly how things are going to come out. All things are going to what? Work together for good for them that what? To them that what? Love the Lord, and to them that are called according to His purpose. Everybody.